Hello friends, I am Dr. Nagaraj from Regional Institute of Education, Mysore. Today, we shall learn the technique of staining of female buccal epithelial cells to study bar body. First, we shall see what is bar body.
Bar body is an inactivated condensed X chromosome found in female cells. In 1940s, Murray Barr discovered a mark of sex chromosome status in bodily tissues, what came to be known as the Barr body. Next, we shall see what is the need of Barr body. Barr bodies are essential to regulate the amount of X-linked gene product, that is dosage compensation. What is dosage compensation? In XY sex determination mechanism, the females have two X chromosomes while the males have just one. This means that the genes located on the X chromosomes are present in double dose in females as compared to the males. Therefore, to compensate this, one of the X chromosome is inactive in female and remains so. The X undergoing condensation may be either of maternal or paternal origin, and the decision by which X chromosome inactive is random. The inactivation occurs early in the embryonic life and remains fixed. Now we shall see where is Barr body found. Barr body is found in the nucleus of somatic cells in female. It can be seen clearly during interphase. Barr bodies are most commonly situated at the periphery of the nucleus. In the nerve cells, it may be near the nucleolus or near the nuclear envelope. In buccal epithelial cells, it is generally attached to the nuclear envelope. In neutrophils, it may be appear as a small rod called drumstick. Next, we shall see what is the number of Barr body in a cell. The number of Barr body at interphase is number of X minus 1, that is 1 less than the total number of X chromosomes in a cell. For example, XX female have 1 Barr body per cell. XXX females have 2 Barr bodies per cell. XXY Klinefelter males have 1 Barr body per cell. Next, what is the frequency of occurrence? In nervous tissue, the frequency may be 85%. In amniotic or chorionic epithelium, it may be as high as 96%. In oral smears, it may vary between 20 and 50%. In normal female. Next, we shall see the practical implications of Barr body. It helps in relating the origin of certain congenital diseases to chromosomal anomalies. Diagnosis of sex in intersexual state in postnatal and in fetal life. Number of Barr bodies give an insight about the abnormal karyotypes of an individual.
Now, let us see what are the materials required.
We need microslides, cover slips, embryo cup, petri dish, dropper, needle, methylene blue stain, dilute glycerin, blotting sheets, ice cream sticks, and combo microscope.
Now, let us see how to do the technique. First, wash the mouth and using an ice cream stick, gently scrape the inner side of the cheek. And make a smear on the slide.
air dry the smear for 5 to 10 minutes to fix the cells. Stain the smear for 3 to 5 minutes by adding 3 to 5 drops of methylene blue stain. And spread it to entire smear by tilting the slide.
Here the question is, why to use methylene blue stain? Because it is a vital and nuclear stain.
After that, wash off the excess stain gently under running tap water. Then air dry the slide, add 1 or 2 drops of dilute glycerin and mount with cover slip. Then blot out the excess glycerin and observe under high power of compound microscope. Record and discuss your observation. Now let us summarize. This is the time for self-evaluation.
I hope you would have understood the technique and enjoyed learning. Thank you.
If you like, please share and subscribe.